How do you respond to the visible elites of climate change who don't realize you've got to get the boxes in Asia from point A to point B?
Well, first, I always say that the shipping is actually the most environmentally free, environmentally way of moving any type of goods. So the CO2 emission that we have per any ton of good moved is quite low compared to road and rail and air. But we still take on the challenge of wanting to reduce our CO2 footprint. And we have articulated more than a year ago an ambition to get to zero CO2 by 2050. And we have solid plans for how to get
there. How do you plan to do that? Talk to us about those plans.
Well, we want to find it. I mean, the obvious is we need to find a different kind of fuel. And we believe that we have fuels that are probable, alcohols, ammonia, biomethane that can be produced from alternative sources.
This is important because it's about the fuel and not about the ship. Because you're in a really, really tough spot. You have to plan a decade, multi-decades ahead from where you are right now. So it's not as simple as saying we're going to build a whole load of new ships. Walk me through the strategic thinking around issues like that.
Well, we believe, first of all, that we have a responsibility as a leader in the industry to drive the agenda. Secondly, as you say, we own assets that have a 25-year lifespan. I cannot be caught up by a regulation that tells me to do something completely different when we operate more than 700 ships. So we need to think ahead.
You are front and center in this new world. Some would suggest that President Trump has moved aggressively from a multilateral Maersk world where trade gets done to some form of bilateral world or almost a mercantile system. How is your business changed with not the trade war, but the many trades war, the new trade dynamic? How's it changed?
Well, clearly, growth is down. Up to the financial crisis, 25 years leading up to the financial crisis 10 years ago, trade was growing 7, 8, 9, 10% per year, trade liberalization and so on. And since then, we've seen much lower levels of growth. And in last year, we believe probably the numbers, when they're all said and done, will come in at slightly less than 2% growth. It's a very low number.
You expect that to pick up? You're seeing improving business in the new year?
I don't think that we'll see much higher trade growth.
It's just going to stay the same?
Yes.
Despite the fact that we have some kind of trade truce between the United States and China?
What we see in our numbers based on the commodities that are being shipped is that actually all of the consumer goods are holding up quite fine across the world. It's the capital goods that are not moving, and that's because business leaders like myself are worried about the future and we invest less.
In your Denmark, and folks, I want to make clear, Denmark is the space of economics of geography in the world. It's the best academics on this that there is. There is the geography of the South China Sea, of Singapore, of Indonesia, and that romantic strait that you've got to get your boats through that strait at night at any time. That must be extraordinary. Give us an update on the ability to move Maersk ships from point A to point B in the South China Sea in the Pacific.
Today we are seeing no impediments or any restrictions or anything that we need to be concerned about. You're right, the Malacca Strait between Singapore and Indonesia is a very narrow channel, but as of today, we don't see any problems there.
You've said trade is basically where it was last year. Don't really see it improving. Let's talk about rates, container rates. You're speaking to your big clients. What have they said so far? What do rates look like and how are things going to evolve in a year ahead?
Freight rates have gone up quite substantially since the 1st of October last year, mainly because we have switched over to a cleaner fuel on the 1st of January, and we're passing that on to the customers.
Well, let's cut to the chase. We're going to have to make some news here. How do your customers receive the new invoice?
Well, it's always a procurement discussion, but at the end of the day, I believe that many, many, many of our customers recognize that it's good for everybody that we go to a cleaner fuel.
Quick final question, just before we let you go. If we can get the Maersk stock out there for people to have a look at, and for our listeners on radio, I'm going to tell you, it is several digits long. Some people always ask me, when are they going to do a stock split? When will Maersk do a stock split? This is getting ridiculous now. When are you going to do a stock split?
I can just say we don't have any plans to do a stock split.